Hey everyone, this is my channel Knowledge Plus Understanding, and in today's video we will talk about the synthesis of indole. We will discuss its reaction and its mechanism. So this is the structure of indole. If we start numbering for the indole, we will start from the nitrogen. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is at this carbon there will be 3 prime or 3A, then 4, 5, 6, 7 or 7 prime or 7A. So in the case of indole, we have started numbering from N, but we can for other heterocycles we can start from other points, like from here, or we can start from this corner, or we can start from anywhere else. So for the case of indole, we start from the numbering from nitrogen. So this is the IUPAC name of indole: 1-hydrogen benzo V pyrrole. So later on in the further videos, I will discuss how this name is come from. So next, there are the some methods of the preparation of indole. Like this is indole Fischer synthesis method. In this video we will talk about this method. We have Madelung synthesis, we have Bischler synthesis, we have Grassmann synthesis, and we have Reiser synthesis. So in this video we will talk about only Fischer indole synthesis, and this is the reaction of Fischer indole synthesis. There we have a phenyl hydrazine. So this is it is attacked on a ketone. And why we are using this ketone? What is the specialty in this ketone? This ketone has a particular alpha hydrogen. This alpha hydrogen is very useful for the closure of this ring. And this reaction occur in the presence of a H positive ion or a Lewis acid. And as the result, we get a substituted indole. We get an indole, but it is substituted. And so we will. These are the conditions. I have already told that we required a ketone which contain alpha hydrogen, which is necessary for ring chlorine. And this reaction occur in the presence of Lewis acid. So next, we will talk about its mechanism. So this is the mechanism. This phenyl hydrazine contain this nitrogen. It contain a lone pair. This lone pair will attack on this carbon, and these electrons will transfer towards this oxygen, and at the result we will get this bond formation, and nitrogen will get a positive charge and this oxygen will get a negative charge. In the next step, this negative charge will attack on the hydrogen, and this hydrogen will give its electron to this nitrogen to make it neutral. So at the result, this we have OH, and here we have another hydrogen. So this hydrogen will transfer its electron toward this bond, and this OH give its at the end this OH is removed. So as a whole, there is a removal of water, and in the as a result of it, there is a formation of anamine. Like this is the structure of anamine. In the next step, there is another hydrogen transfer. This nitrogen will attack again at contain a lone pair, which will again attack on a proton. So we will get there is a attachment of this hydrogen, and nitrogen will get positive charge. In the next step, this bond will transfer toward nitrogen to neutralize it, but before it, there is a in the next step we have CH2. But in the next step, one of the hydrogen the transfer its proton toward this bond between this carbon and this carbon. As a result, we have a double bond, and this hydrogen this proton will be removed. In the next step, there will be again a proton transfer, and this proton will nitrogen this lone pair on nitrogen will transfer its proton will move toward this proton, and as a result of it we have NH2 positive. This is the nitrogen will get positive charge. In the next step, this bond of carbon will attack on the this corner, and but there we have this bond of benzene will attack on, will share its proton towards this. As a result, there is a destruction of the aromaticity of the benzene ring. But there is a further, this bond will transfer towards this from at the end, there is a ring closure. In the next step, there is a again proton transfer reaction. As a result, this proton will be transferred and this bond will be transferred toward this nitrogen, and this after that transfer of this electron toward in the ring, this nitrogen will capture this hydrogen. There will get NH2 and nitrogen get positive charge. And so why this nitrogen capture this hydrogen, this proton? It is because this aromatic ring again complete its aromaticity. In the next step, this double bond of nitrogen will again attack on this carbon, and again nitrogen get positive charge, and this bond will transfer toward N positive, and we have NH2, and this bond will transfer toward this nitrogen to neutralize it, but this nitrogen again get positive charge. In the next step, this nitrogen containing lone pair will attack on this proton, this hydrogen. This hydrogen will transfer its proton toward this nitrogen to neutralize it, and as a result we have NH3 positive. So in the next step, this bond between NH3 will share it NH3 positive toward this. As a result we have this proton will transfer its proton toward this ring to make this bond, and as a result this ammonia is released. So as a result, at the end of the reaction, this ammonia is released. So it is clear that this was a catalyst used in this reaction. So as a result we have a substituted indole. But in the start of the reaction, if we use here, if we can use here, let's say from start of reaction, if we use this R like methyl group CH3 or ethyl C2H5 or propyl C3H7, so at the end of the reaction we will get this here. But if we have a electron donating group in on this ring, then it will cause the proton sharing, proton donating ability of this nitrogen. So it will enhance the rate of reaction. If we have electron withdrawing group attack at para or ortho position, it will decrease the rate of reaction. So this is all about the Fischer indole synthesis, and in this synthesis we get a substituted indole by the reaction of phenyl hydrazine with a ketone that contains a alpha hydrogen in the presence of Lewis acid. Thank you.